This is a quick video to demonstrate how we find competitive equilibrium in the Edgeworth box. These blue axes over here with the origin over here are for consumer A. This is actually the origin for the entire economy. These red axes over here are for consumer B, and this corner point represents B's origin right at that corner. This green allocation, let me click away from this for a second here. This green dot is the initial allocation for A measured from this origin to the green point. You can also read it as the allocation for B measured from this red origin to the green point. We have controls here to change the way the economy is set up, so we can increase the amount of good X that Agent A has and that the economy as a whole has, and that moves the green dot and the entire box to the right. I'm going to now move that back to where it was. I believe it was at 20. Likewise, I can increase the amount of X for consumer B. When I do that, the economy moves to the right, but the green dot does not change. So I'm going to move that back to 60, which I believe is where it was. I can do the same sort of thing for good Y. So this is increasing the amount of good Y for consumer A. And let's move that back to 75. And I can increase the amount of good Y for consumer B, which does not move the green dot. And let's move that back to 25. This is the budget line. This slanted line here goes through the original allocation. This is consumer A's choice point on the budget line. This is consumer B's choice point on the budget line. Oh, it even says it. See, it comes up very nicely there. And what we can do, the other control that we have, is to change the relative price. So if I lower the relative price and make the budget line flatter, the choices will change. Note that the budget line can actually go extend outside the box. The budget line is the same slope line for each consumer, but it's relative to their own axes. So the budget line can go outside the box, but any consistent choice for the economy has to be inside the box. So let's now try to find the competitive equilibrium. This is when A's choice and B's choice coincide. I'm going to start raising the relative price here a little bit, if I can get this thing to click. And as I'm raising it, it looks like the dots are moving closer together. This economy has Cobb-Douglas preferences for both Agent A and Agent B, and those preferences are such that the equilibrium relative price is proportional to the aggregate amount of Y in the economy, which is 100, 75 plus 25 is 100, to the aggregate amount of X, which is 80, 20 plus 60 is 80. So the equilibrium relative price is 100 over 80, and let's see if I can actually get those points to line up when I reach that equilibrium relative price. And we're getting very close, and there it is. And you see the orange dot, which is B's choice. You cannot see A's choice. It's completely covered up by B's. So there is the equilibrium in a snap.